Hey there, Mr. Reddit here. Welcome back to another episode of r/EntitledParentStories. Our first story we'll be reading today. Entitled lady tries to take my surfboard after trespassing on private property. After that, irritating vegan coworker takes office pranks way too far, so I destroy her entire paradigm. And after that, entitled mom tried to get her daughter my job because I'm chubby. Now for every thumbs up this video gets, one Karen breaks a nail. So please smash that like button, and if you're new, subscribe and turn on notifications for new stories from Reddit every single day. Entitled lady tries to take my surfboard after trespassing on private property. So to set the scene, I live in a very small beach town in North Carolina. We get a crazy amount of tourists in the summer months, but not quite as much as Myrtle Beach, a large city in South Carolina, one of the most popular on the East Coast outside of Florida. We get our fair share of native tourists, and during my time as a lifeguard, I probably got asked 3,000 questions about sharks or jellyfish or stingrays in a day. Instead of saving people from the water, I spent most of my time telling people to stay off the dunes or telling people not to swim up to boats. So anyway, the cast composed of myself, a naive entitled tourist, and her naive entitled son. So anyway, I saw that there was supposed to be some excellent surf one day and decide to head to the beach for a little shredding action. My beach access is part of a private neighborhood and is paid for by my homeowners association, which means that it is private property. Once I get up to it, I see a middle-aged woman and her son, who is maybe 6 or 7, standing at the gate, holding floats. I think, great, I have a little arguing to do, because people are supposed to stay off unless they pay taxes for it to be maintained. I walk up and the convo goes a little like this. Entitled mom: hey, what is the code for this beach access? Me: well, it's a private access. Are you visiting? I haven't seen your face around here. Where are you staying? Entitled mom points at a house that isn't part of the HOA. It was developed after my neighborhood was. Me: oh, that house is part of a different neighborhood. That one uses a public access. See where the sidewalk is? Entitled mom: oh, come on. It's right across the street. Just tell us the code. Me: no, ma'am. This access is paid for by our own taxes. There is a public access literally 50 feet to the left with no code. No. I demand that you let me and my son through, or I will call the police. Me: go ahead. In the meantime, I'm going to use the public access. If you care to join me on the beach, then you can follow me on that access. I left her and her son red-faced like that and walked to the public access. About 10 minutes go by, and I kind of forgot about the pair. I'm putting wax on my board and waiting for my friend to show up in the meantime. I turn around from my board to head down and look at the water and look for a good spot or a rip current. And lo and behold, I see the kid trying to lift my board and his mom grinning at him. Keep in mind, my board is a 9-foot beast that has to weigh at least 50 pounds. My dad got it in Maui 20 years ago from a custom board store that's no longer open, and it cost at least $700 to $800. I run back up to the pair, and my usually good nature was out the window. Me: hey lady, get the heck off my stuff. Entitled mom: how dare you speak to me like that? Me: I'll speak to you however I want. Tell your son to stop grabbing at my stuff. At this point, he had it fins up and was sitting on it, which is a massive no-no for surfing. It curves upwards, so if you put too much weight on it, it might snap. I yanked it out from under him, and he fell forward into the sand. Entitled mom: get away from my son. I'm going to sue you until you need to file for bankruptcy. Me: what the heck, lady? I'm defending my property. You can't sue me. Jerk. My baby just wanted to see it. He wasn't hurting anyone. At this point, her son is bawling, and he is screaming something along the lines of, mommy, he broke my rib. Me: grow up, kid. Lady, don't touch my stuff again, or I will call the police on you. At this point, a lot of people around me are angry at the lady, and I notice my friend has shown up and has a huge grin on his face. When I look away to make a face at him, the lady tries to yank the board out of my hands. I just let it drop. It falls on her, and she buries herself in the sand. I snatch it back up from her and jerk a thumb at my friend to run to the water. I turn to the kid and I say, don't turn out like your mother. I then turn and run towards the water with my friend and fill him in. And from what we can see from the waves, the lady is getting shamed off of the beach by other beachgoers, most of whom knew me and knew I wouldn't fly off the handle unless it was something crazy. That's about it. Nothing much compared to some of the absolute BS I've seen on this sub, but still a wake up to me that people like that exist. Irritating vegan coworker takes off his pranks way too far, so I destroy her entire paradigm. At the time, I was a 7-year veteran at a large tech corporation, senior designer on the communications team by then. The senior copywriter went on maternity leave, leaving a temp in her place. Although irritating in a nondescriptive way, she presented well and seemed competent enough. For later context, she was also an Uber dog lover and a staunch and righteous vegan. There were frequent, mutual, and innocent team pranks. Things like replacing a box of diet cookies with a box of Krispy Kremes or covering the laser on someone's mouse. Like, oh, you dog, you got me, kind of things. Now let me fix that and let you get back to work. Being desperate for acceptance, new temps started taking things a bit far and seemed to focus pranks directly towards me. Even after a few subtle reprimands from our manager, she continued. Things like slipping inappropriate photos or comments into a PowerPoint presentation on the shared drive I was about to give, or fake crying during morning stand-up just to gauge reactions, her novelty wore off fast. Fast forward to the morning after my birthday, she knew I was going to be hungover. I got to my desk, red-eyed and thirsty as heck, grabbed my water bottle at my desk, which I always kept full, and started chugging like it was going to save my life. It was straight vodka. At least 2 full swallows before I realized. I go straight from my garbage bin to throw up. The slurry of alphabet soup, at least 6 cans of beer, and God knows what else she put in there, made sure I did hurl. She came in laughing her brains out, taking full claim. I didn't snitch on her, but the story made its rounds to human resources and she was given a stern warning. I would have accepted an apology, even remorse, but not a shred. In fact, she started calling me Pukey McGee to literally no one's fanfare. I let it pass for a few weeks, waiting for the attention to die down. Revenge day finally arrived. She always left at 10 a.m. to get a Starbucks. I took this time to plaster lost dog posters anywhere outside the office she might stumble by on her way back. She fell for the bait, asking around, but no one was the wiser. Once she was cozy at her desk, I went to her car to stage a hit and run with chunks of fatty steak, an old leash and collar, and a bag of fake fur. I went to work. I'd share the pic, but it's long gone, but it was very convincing. Looked like a leash was caught around her rear passenger axle and the dog got clogged between the tire and wheel well. I left the collar dangling out the back. It didn't take long before even others noticed the lost dog posters or the car and put 2 and 2 together. Eventually, the owner of a white so-and-so with license plate such-and-such, please come to reception, went over the intercom. It's on. It was delicious. She was out in the lot sobbing so hard she was coughing, carefully placing all the chunks into a box. It took her an hour to gather every precious bit, crying the entire time. My theory was that she wanted to return the dog to its owner as best she could before calling the number on the poster. Was a shame there was no owner or dog, but she was too distraught to realize it was fake. I thought for sure the lack of bones would be a near instant giveaway, but to my utter shock, it wasn't. A scenario I wasn't expecting, but welcomed just the same. It was just assumed the dog owner had printed the wrong number on the poster because the remains were never returned. She had the collar and leash cleaned and posted pictures of her own in hopes of finding the owner. Given her reputation, there wasn't much sympathy offered. She took down all her dog lover crap off her desk and kept very much to herself for the remainder of her term. Bonus that she even left early, but not sure if I can take credit for that for certain. Disclaimer, for those that will likely claim she just liked me and wanted my attention, I assure you that was not the case. There's way more background than just this story. Even if it were, this was in adulthood, not grade school. Edit. Thought I should clear up a few things based on the comments. 1. OP is not a vegan, however is a huge animal lover, owns several dogs, cats, and has rescued many animals. OP has nothing against vegans, just the ones that preach it. Relevant distinction for her personality and subsequent reaction, not the reason for revenge. Steak bits was an easier way of describing a bag of butcher scraps at the time. 4. To make it clear to the ones that thought this was petty revenge for minor inconveniences, Here's a list of some of the more inconvenient pranks. Replacing water with vodka was just the last straw. Hiding car keys, then leaving. Wasted hours of people's lives, but was welcome news to cab companies. Pulling fuses from cars is dangerous. Again, could be fatal. Brake lights, headlights, airbags, all very important, you should think, right? In hindsight, I do regret not coming clean. The believability was not expected, and I froze. But the pranks most definitely stopped. When bullies don't get the point from a passive and apathetic authority, the only route is to pop them straight in the nose good and hard. Entitled mom tried to get her daughter my job because I'm chubby. I'm female and home from college. The stay-at-home order in my town is slowly being lifted, so some businesses are finally opening up. My parents require me to have a summer job. I'm blessed enough that I get to keep all the money I earn. My parents just like me to work to gain experience. This will be relevant later, but I'm not a skinny girl. I wouldn't consider myself large either. I'm 5'6 and weigh about 140 to 145 pounds right now and carry most of it in my hips and thighs. The freshman 15 did hit me hard though, as I used to be 120-ish. So today, after finishing my last online final, my dad called me. He told me that one of his friends who runs a heating slash AC company texted him and that they were looking for girls to work in the office, answering phones and stuff. I got excited because that's exactly what I wanted. So I put on a dress, printed a copy of my resume, and drove down. The ladies inside were super nice and asked me to fill out an application, so I sat down to do so. And this is where the entitled mom enters. Here's everyone involved. We've got entitled mom. We've got entitled girl, probably 16-ish. We've got me. We've got desk lady 1. This woman is relatively thin, which will be relevant later. We've got desk lady 2. Desk further back, still in the room. This woman is plus size, which will be relevant later. And we've got the boss of the business. We're in the South, which might be relevant, because typically for jobs like this, they're looking for a pretty face to sit behind the counter and talk to customers. This is unspoken though. Yes, it's awful, but hey, I needed a job. So as I'm filling out an application, entitled mom enters with entitled girl. She announces that she's here about the opening and her daughter would like to apply. Desk lady 1 explains that she'll need to fill out an application and hands her one and a pen. They come sit in the lobby right beside me, which I thought was weird, but I didn't say anything. Entitled mom tells me, "Are you here for the job as well?" Me, "Yes, ma'am." You know that little jerk sound people make? I ignored her and went up to ask desk lady 1 a question about the application. It was about how professional one of my references for babysitting was. When I returned and sat back down, entitled mom walked up to the desk. "Does my daughter even really need to fill this out?" Desk lady 1, "It's protocol. Boss will look at all the applications and decide who to call for an interview." "Is he here? I'm sure if he could see my daughter, he'd know who he wanted to call." Desk lady 1, "He is, but he isn't seeing visitors right now." Entitled mom, "How will he know who to hire if he doesn't know what the girls look like?" Lady 1, "Well, he will need to see their references and will make a few calls before he—" "No, my daughter is an aspiring model. She won," insert local pageant, "in 2019. He needs to see her to know she's the face he wants to see behind the counter interacting with customers." Lady 1, "I'm not sure what you mean. This isn't a modeling job. Looks don't really matter." "Oh, I know, but they do. Let's face it, boss isn't going to want—" At this point, she leans in closer to Lady 1. "A chubby girl up here, is he?" This whole time, entitled girl is smirking at me in glances as she fills out her application. This caught the attention of Desk Lady 2 as well as me, and we both looked up at this point. Desk Lady 2, "Ma'am, I'm not sure I know what you mean."
"Oh, no disrespect. I just know the boss personally, and know he'd prefer a new, pretty face around the office. Maybe I'm a little biased, but I think there's no question between my daughter and, well, this young lady, for example." Me, "No offense, honey. Just trying to save you some time."
At this point, I'm in tears. I don't know if it was rage or the sting of her insult, but either way, I was not going to let her see me cry. So I quickly got up and handed my application to Desk Lady 1 before trying to leave. Desk Lady 2, a plus size lady, "Sweetie, wait," talking to me. Lady 2, "You say you know the boss personally, right?" To entitled mom,
"Oh yes, we went to high school together." And you know him so well that you know he'd prefer a skinny woman behind this desk?
Well, I didn't say that.
She did.
But I'd assume so.
Great. Well, I'm his wife, and I've worked behind this desk for almost 15 years now. And as you can see, I could probably drop a few. And I take personal offense to what you're saying about my husband and this young lady. So I'd like you to wait in the car while your daughter fills out her application. Entitled Mom and Entitled Girl both stormed out at this point. Entitled Girl took her application, so I don't know if she'll apply or not. But both women behind the counter told me that Entitled Mom was a jerk and they had vouched for me with the boss. So I'm hopeful that I'll get the job. Entitled Mom is angry I got my order first because I ordered online. Takes it out on the server, who I shower in cash. I ordered some pasta and mozzarella sticks from a local pizza joint for lunch today. I use their Google checkout to order and pay and put my info into the pickup notes. My phone bings and my food is done, so I scoot a mile down the road to the pizza place to pick it up. I pull up behind a minivan and call the number. Get put on hold while she talks to the entitled mom in front of me. I can hear the whole conversation because she's using her car speakers turned up to the max and she's screaming into the steering wheel. Entitled Mom.
I'm here to pick up an order.
Pizza Girl. What was the name on it?
Helen.
Pizza Girl. I'm not seeing an order for Helen. Did you place it online or call in?
I didn't place it yet.
Sorry about that. I misunderstood you. What can I get you?
This is why you work at a pizza dive, hun.
Rattles off on a long list of stuff, including three pizzas. Pizza Girl. No problem. We'll get that ready for you. It will be done in about 30 minutes.
You can't go any faster? My kids are hungry.
This is the lunch rush. I'll put a flyer in your bag. It has the store number, and next time you can call ahead so we have it ready for you.
Ugh.
Entitled Mom hangs up. Pizza Girl immediately picks up my line. I give her my name, and she brings out my bag. It's a small paper bag, and obviously doesn't contain three large pizzas. As soon as she steps out the door, Entitled Mom starts screaming at her.
Is that my food? Why are you giving her my food?
Pizza Girl. This is her order. She called ahead.
I was here first, and I already told you my kids are hungry.
She ordered ahead. Your order is being prepared. Please be patient.
Ugh.
She starts yelling at her kids to shut up. At this point, I'm ready to give this girl a medal, because I was barely hanging on to my temper. Instead, I thanked her profusely for my food, told her that she was doing an amazing job, and tipped her $20 on an $8 order. Not sure how it went down with Entitled Mom after that, but I hope wherever you are, you're having a better day now, Pizza Girl.
Put my friend on the phone now.
I manage an automotive repair center in the southern US. This morning, I had a very nice elderly lady walk in. She was wearing the new formal face mask and rubber gloves and asks us to diagnose a few issues that she was having with her vehicle. I proceeded to check her in and she was elected to sit quietly in the lobby. An hour later, her friend calls and the following conversation ensues. Cast, we've got me and we've got Entitled Old Lady. Me. Thank you for calling our company. This is me. How may I help you? Entitled Old Lady.
Yes, this is Entitled Old Lady. My friend was going to bring her vehicle in for y'all to look at, and I wanted to see if she made it in.
Me. Yes, ma'am. She's here, and we're looking at her vehicle now.
That's nice. Can you put her on the phone for me?
Ma'am, I'm terribly sorry, but with what's going on right now, we're closely following the guidelines, and that includes not sharing phones. I would be more than happy to relay a message to her and relay her response back to you, if you would like.
That's ridiculous. She's not sick, and you don't sound sick, so just put her on the phone.
I understand that she doesn't appear to be sick, but that's not how this works. We're trying to keep all of our customers and employees safe by following the guidelines, so I will be happy to relay a message to your friend, but again, we're not sharing phones.
Well, bless your heart.
This is Southern speak for you're an idiot.
You are the rudest and most annoying person I've ever had to speak with. Now, unless you want me to speak with your manager, and make no mistake, I will have you fired. Put my friend on the phone now.
Me. Ma'am, I am the manager, and I'm not going to continue tying up the phone lines and my time by arguing in circles with you. Now, unless you would like me to relay a message to your friend, I'm going to have to say have a great day and end this call.
Well, bless your heart. I'm going to call your boss, corporate, my attorney, the local news station.
Me.
I've had enough at this point, and rudely interrupted her tirade. Ma'am, I have the number for the governor's office and our state and local reps, if you would like those also.
What?
She said the what's kind of slow and drawn out, like she was trying to figure out if I had insulted her or if I was serious.
You know what? We're done. I'll just call my friend on her cell phone.
Click, she hangs up. 2 seconds later, the customer's cell phone rings in the lobby, and she asks entitled old lady why she wasted 5 minutes of my time arguing instead of just calling her on the cell phone to begin with. Customer apologized for the entitled old lady when we were finished with her vehicle and tipped both myself and the tech that worked on her vehicle for our troubles. Entitled mother tries to use me to get family discount at the cinema. Background: I'm currently 21, female, but I've always had a baby face that makes me look younger than I am. I'm often thought to be 15 or 16, and people treat me like a kid until I call them out on it. It can be convenient at times, as up until 2 years ago, if I went to the cinema and just asked for a ticket, age unspecific, they'd just automatically give me a kid ticket. Characters: we've got myself and we've got entitled mom. So I was 16 at the time, but looked around 9 or 10, and was waiting in line at the cinema to get a ticket. I forget what movie, as it was a long time ago. Directly in front of me was a family of three. At the time, you could get a discount if you had 2 adults and 2 kids by buying a family ticket, which was less than buying 3 separate tickets. There were a few people in front of us, and I'd noticed the 2 parents staring at me and whispering to each other. I wear a lot of anime tops, so I'm fairly used to that behavior, so I mostly ignored it. The family gets to the counter, and entitled mom very loudly stated that they want a family ticket to a U-rated movie. The cashier, of course, tells her you have to have 2 kids for that, at which entitled mom turns around, points at me, and says,
"She's with us."
I naturally look at her like she's got 2 heads and say, "No, I'm not." Entitled mom puts on that real condescending, smoothie tone adults use with bold kids and says,
"Honey, don't act up in public. Just come here."
While her family cross their arms and stare at me like I just did something wrong, I glared at her and walked over to the second cashier and said, "One adult ticket for the movie," and showed them my passport for ID. The cashier, of course, charges me and gives me my ticket. Entitled mom starts spluttering at the worker for
allowing kids to buy tickets to those types of movies.
Both cashiers just barely hid rolling their eyes as the one in front of her asked her what tickets she wanted. I trotted off to the necessary screen and left them at the counter to deal with it by themselves. Sir, she doesn't work here. About 6 months ago, I was at my local health food where I regularly shop. Enough to know employees' faces, but not names. I have pretty bad social anxiety, in part due to the fact that I'm a pretty good-looking girl and tend to get a lot of unwanted attention. I usually avoid dressing nice and wearing makeup because I would just rather avoid solicitation as much as possible, despite the fact that I love dressing up. It's also hot where I live, which means it's not always practical to wear full-length garments. On this particular day, I was wearing cargo pants and a tank top. For some background, I've been followed out of the store 2 times by creeps, luckily with no physical harm thanks to evasion and quick thinking by good Samaritans. Anywho, so I'm in the small health food store, card in hand, picking up yogurt along with a few other things. An older man in his 70s is standing in front of the yogurt section looking a bit confused. I slip in front of him to grab what I was looking for. Older man:
"I'm wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for a special yogurt, but I'm having trouble reading the labels."
I don't really mind because I like sweet grandpas and I'm also in the helping profession. He goes on to explain what he's looking for, and it happens that I know exactly where his item was because I recently was on keto, which requires extensive label reading. He explained it was for his wife because she was on a special diet. Me: "Sure, not a problem. In fact, I was just on a diet that had similar requirements, so I understand how difficult it is to find what you're looking for." I quickly pick out his product and gave some suggestions to pass along to his wife. I had spent a considerable amount of time being polite and wanted to get back to my own shopping. Meanwhile, the store is pretty small and we had been standing in front of a popular area where people were trying to access the products. Older man:
"Oh, thank you. Would you mind helping me find one more thing?"
Me: "Sure."
"I'm looking for XYZ."
"Sure." It happened to be in the same approximate area, so I found it and turned away when he asked again.
"Oh, can you help me find ABC?
At this point, I was starting to get really uncomfortable because it was pretty clear at this point he did not have a good sense of boundaries. My red flag warning started going off. Employee who knows I'm a regular steps in. Sir, she doesn't work here.
Oh, I know. I was just asking for help.
He turns back to me and keeps talking. Employee. Sir, please leave her alone. She's allowed to shop here in peace. If you need help, ask me, but leave her alone.
Oh no, it's okay. I was just getting her help.
Continues to debate with the employee to get back to me. The employee steps in between older man and myself. It was a bit of a spectacle since there was a foot traffic jam around us. It's a small store and we'd been there for a while. I quickly made my way to the front, hoping I could get out quickly and not have to see the older man again. At this point, I'm feeling a bit shaky and ready to just leave. As I do, another employee who apparently heard most of the exchange also makes her way to the front. She empathizes with me and takes me to an open register to have me checked out quickly. As I'm paying, the cashier starts talking to me. He has no idea what just happened in the back of the store. Cashier. Nice tattoo. What's it about? I just ignore him because in my mind, there's no way a cashier on duty would be hitting on a customer in front of another employee. My back is to him and I'm literally checking out while another customer waits in line behind me. A few seconds go by and I look over my shoulder and he's looking at me. Cashier. Nice tattoo. What's the meaning behind it? It's really nice. I'm thinking to myself, are you kidding me? You think right now is a good place and time for me to explain my tattoo? You're totally cool with flirting with me right now? I gave him some kind of curt answer, the universal sign of, leave me alone please. Cashier doesn't get the hint and continues trying to talk to me. The cashier checking me out at my register, who had seen my previous encounter, was completely mortified. I rush out of the store and thankfully didn't run into older man. A few weeks later, I caught up with the employee who intervened with older man and explained how I really appreciated him standing up for me. He was glad to have been there and told me it's important that customers feel safe when they shop there. I never saw older man or the flirty cashier again, thankfully. And shoutouts to our regenerals of the day, Weird Alley Cat, Exterminator, and Midnight Gamer. And please listen to my playlist every night when you go to sleep.